Hey guys, thanks for joining me again. Today I'm doing a little bit of an unboxing and a bit of a review. But the question is, what's in this fancy sucker? Let's have a look. The old trusty knife on the go. Really needs a new blade on it, to be honest. I'm not one of these YouTubers that has a, you know, big fancy crafting knife or whatever. I'm not an outdoorsy kind of guy. I just have a standard one that has Stanley blades in it. But this one, well, put it this way. If you wanted to do anyone harm with this, you'd struggle. You'd be better off using a blunt kitchen knife. Now, carefully open this because we are going to need to reuse the box. I don't want to destroy it. All right. Okay, let me put this down here. Well, I mean, I was going to say, can you guess what it is? But probably you can because of the title of the video. So, it is the Antelope Orion 32 Plus Gen 4. Cool, let's have a look in the inside of the box. Alright, so the important thing, do not accept if damaged. Well, I can tell you, the seal is not damaged yet. Let's get that sucker open. And there's one on the other side. Okay. What have we got? Trying not to get you a shitty camera angle. I'm not exactly well equipped to do these unboxing videos. Nice foam top. Let me see if I can take you inside. We've got the actual Antelope itself, power cables. Let me get you a better angle and we'll pull this sucker out. Alright, so one EU power cable, not going to be needing that, already got one. Power brick, this fucker will focus. Nice power brick, standard. Ooh, that's fancy though. It's got, I don't know if you can see that, but it has a screw-on adapter. Well, isn't that something? Never seen that before. Getting started card, don't care. And, oh, the main event. Oh, yes. Oh, not to forget, trusty USB cable, which I believe we will need to configure the unit, because I'm pretty sure, or if it's anything like the Gen 3, it doesn't like being configured over Thunderbolt. It really doesn't like it. So let's stick that gubbins back in there. We don't need that. The getting started card we don't really care about. Random packaging which we may need at some unspecified later date. Let's pull the USB cable out because we are going to wind up needing that. Go in there, stick the lid back on, and into the loft you go. Alright, so there she is. What a delightful looking device. Oh, I see they've gone with four rack holes this time instead of two that was on the Gen 3. That's nice. Smells like a factory. Delightful, that electronic smell. It's like heroin. Okay, good set of cabling on the back, which is pretty much exactly the same as the last one, apart from now, I believe you've got extra maddies. And of course, the best part, which is Thunderbolt 3. Delightful. Right. I'm going to get this installed and then we're going to look at the other stuff that comes with it. Bear with me. As you can see, there is a hell of a lot of a cable in behind here, which is going to make it an absolute nightmare to switch the two units over. But we press on. All right, so we're in the new Antelope software. This is what the new one looks like. First thing I notice is it's a hell of a lot cleaner looking than the previous one. And the first thing that jumps out at me is the fact that you can hide anything that you're no longer using just by clicking these. So I'm not using Surround, Spadiff I'm not using, ADAT I'm not using, MADI I'm not using, MADI IN I'm not using. This is very interesting. Door out I'm not using, I'm using line ins. And on here I'm using line outs, monitors, and everything else can be hidden. Because essentially, I know that the Antelope comes with a bunch of fancy features, but I don't use any of them. I basically use it as an AD converter, which is nice. Door in we will also need, I believe, and door out. So the door outs go to line out, and then the door ins, and then the line ins go to the door ins, I believe. Which should give us ins and outs working nicely. Also, you now have a separate monitor in and out, which hopefully, to be decided, works separately to. So on the Antelope Gen 3, it was 32 I/O, but the monitor outs were duplicated from one of the other inputs and out. One of the other outputs. So it was actually 30 out, 32 in, because you had to lose two outputs because they had to be mirrored. And the way Pro Tools sees it is, let's say I'm sending out one and two to a compressor, well, it sends the full monitor out in there rather than the actual source. So it's really annoying. This one, I am told on the packaging, has a separate DA for monitor outs. So hopefully that is no longer a problem. But to be discovered shortly. Let's have a look at the trims. Now what I do know is that 5 and 6 on mine, they have to be set to manual, and they have to be set to 18 because the LA3As are quite hot. So I like to set them out to 18. Channel 1, channel 2, they can be set to 0. That's cool. Sample rate needs to be on 48. Is there anything else we need to know about here? TB latency can be on normal, DC coupled inputs, DC coupled outputs. I'm going to leave that as it is for now. Monitor trim is there. Panning law, 4.5. I'm going to leave these as default. We'll set that to 32, why not? Even though I'm not using USB, but nice to know. That's pretty much that, to be honest. Alright, so I have everything set up in Pro Tools now, exactly as it was before. Pros and cons. Having timed the hardware insert delay, this Antelope is a little bit quicker than the previous one. So there's less latency on the input and output, which is cool. The downside is the dedicated monitor outs, as per the marketing material, is horseshit. They've still not fixed that. And what that means is, inside the Antelope software, you have to give up two of your analog outputs if you're working in Pro Tools. So the way Pro Tools works with hardware inserts is the input has to match the output. So, for instance, I have a Smart C2, which is on out 1 and 2. So when you do a hardware insert, out 1 and 2 has to match in 1 and 2. Well, the problem is, with the Antelope, it has to mirror a set of the outs for the monitor output. So therefore, your C2 cannot be used as a hardware insert on 1 and 2, because Pro Tools thinks that 1 and 2 is already in use for the monitors. So you basically have to give up a pair of outs. Now, luckily for me, I use a summing mixer, so 11 and 12 out are not actually being used for me for anything, because the inputs 11 and 12 are being used for the sum return. So they're free, so I can make the monitor outs 11 and 12, which makes 1 and 2 active. But again, it's the same problem that was on the Generation 3, which is you lose outputs to be able to hear anything, which to me is ridiculous, because Universal Audio don't have this problem with the Apollo. Their software allows you to stagger the ins and outs so that Pro Tools sees 1 and 2 as 1 and 2, but it's actually 3 and 4. It still means that you get all your I.O., it just means that the software staggers it slightly to allow the monitor outs to be used independently. Why Antelope can't do this, I do not know. So Antelope, if you're watching this, please fix it, because that's some bullshit. And I would assume in the software terms it would be a fairly easy fix. So please fix it. Other than that, build quality wise, the unit's fantastic. It's exactly the same as the Gen 3, aside the addition of the volume knob, which again doesn't matter to me because it is a monitor controller, but for those of you that don't, that's a great addition, because before you had to adjust the monitor volume inside the software, which was a pain in the ass. So that's a good addition. IO is relatively unchanged from the Gen 3. It just slots straight in the rack. Job done. I do like the way the new software looks, and if you're going to use the digital patching capabilities that it has, it's a hell of a lot easier than the Gen 3 software, so that's a massive pro. Other than that, I've not really got much else to say. Gets a thumbs up from me. The monitor thing does piss me off, I've got to be honest, but aside from that, it's fantastic. The drivers are super stable, the low latency, no issues with it whatsoever. So, recommend. I mean, to be honest, bang for buck in the price point, I don't see anything that competes with it that has 30 outs and 32 ins. I mean, I really don't see anything else that competes with it. If there is something out there that is competitive with the Antelope, do let me know below. I'd be interested to know. Anyway, thanks for checking this out, and I'll see you again in the next video.